The final day of competition at the Richmond Oval, and this was the women's team pursuit. The United States lining up in the race for the bronze medal. The Canadians had failed to make the last four despite their star names, and it was the Polish team, surprisingly, providing the opposition. And the Poles in the red, off to a smart start. They'd been quicker than the USA in the semi-finals, but the Americans were very experienced. They had Catherine Rainey Norman, 33-year-old Jennifer Rodriguez, the former world champion in inline speed skating, and Jillian Rukard, who was making the running in the early part of the race. Poland led by Luiza Słodkowska. Four laps to go, and the Americans ahead by 0.17 of a second. The team members taking it in turns to lead while the others skated in their slipstream. Poland now with Katarzyna Bachleder-Kurus up front. And with two laps to go, the USA had increased their lead to more than half a second. But by the final bend, the Poles had fought right back. Słodkowska again making the pace, and it was a storming finish by the young Polish team. The USA, with Catherine Rainey Norman suffering an agonizing last lap, had been beaten by more than 1.5 seconds, the clock stopping only when the final team member crossed the line. And lots of emotion in the Polish camp. Bachleder-Kurus, Wozniacz, and Słodkowska, the surprise bronze medalists. And so, the final speed skating race of Vancouver 2010. Japan were about to take on the favorites, the Olympic champions, Germany. Starting on the opposite side, wearing red armbands, the reigning... Go... Japan, who'd clocked the quickest time of all in the semi-finals. But the Germans have brought in fresh legs for the final in the shape of Katrin Matscherot, and she made the early pace. But with five laps to go, the Japanese have built up a good lead, more than half a second on the Olympic champions. Maki Tabata pacemaking for them, with Masako Hosumi and Nao Kodaira tucked in behind. And with four laps to go, their lead was almost 1.5 seconds. Germany now had Stephanie Beckert up front, already a double silver medalist at the Games, while Japan had given the responsibility to Masako Hosumi. And the Japanese continuing to pour on the power. Two laps to go, and the lead was 1.72 seconds, and surely not even the Olympic champions could bridge that gap. But they dug deep, and they were clawing their way back. Now it would be a sprint to the finish. Japan hitting the last straight, leading by a fraction, but the Germans were still coming. And the finish was oh so close. But Germany had paced their race to perfection. They were the champions. They had retained their Olympic crown. The winning margin, just 0.02 of a second. The Japanese team had almost sprung a big surprise by snatching the gold, but these were the winners. The team pursuit had been introduced to the Olympic program only 4 years earlier in Turin, and here in Vancouver, it had provided a thrilling finale to the speed skating competition. The bronze medalists of Poland, Katarzyna Bachleder-Kurus, Katarzyna Wozniacz, and Luiza Słodkowska. The Japanese team, Masako Hosumi, Nao Kodaira, and Maki Tabata. They'd been the fastest in the semis, their time in the final just 0.1 of a second slower. But that was enough to let the Germans in. It was silver for Japan. And the gold once more to Germany. The three finalists now joined by the fourth member of their squad, Anna Friesinger-Posma, who'd raced in both the quarter and the semi-final. The Richmond Oval would pay tribute to the athletes one last time. Ladies and gentlemen. And time for the last of the anthems. And the proud faces of the Olympic champions, Katrin Matscherot from Berlin, Anna Friesinger-Posma, who sat out the final but played her part, 21-year-old Stephanie Beckert, already a silver medalist in the 3,000 and the 5,000, and Daniela Anschutz-Toms at 35, savoring Olympic gold in this event for the second time. Germany, with a team pursuit Olympic champions.